All right, here we're going to talk about the Pythagorean theorem. Now, for the Pythagorean theorem to apply, you need to be given a right triangle. So I have a right triangle here. We're going to label this angle A, this angle B, and this here angle C. Typically, in this course, we're going to label the length of the side opposite of angle A with a little a, the side opposite of angle B with little b, and the side opposite of angle C with little c. Okay? So doing that, we can then say for the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. In other words, leg squared plus leg squared has to equal the hypotenuse squared. The hypotenuse is the longest side. All right, so let's do an example. Let's say we were given a right triangle where the base here is given to be, say, 3 centimeters, and the height is 4 centimeters, and we want to find the hypotenuse. Okay, so we can apply the Pythagorean theorem. Leg squared plus leg squared equals hypotenuse squared, and then just do the work. All right, so in this case, we have 9 plus 16 equals x squared, or 25 equals x squared. You got to get out from under the x squared. You take the square root of both sides. When you do that, don't forget the plus or minus. And we get plus or minus 5 equals x. Now, since this is geometry, we're going to choose x to be positive, right? So 5 centimeters. And then this is your famous 3, 4, 5 right triangle. All right, awesome. Let's do another one. So this time, let's be given the hypotenuse. So we want to find one of the legs. Alright, so let's say the hypotenuse is given to be 10 centimeters, and I know the base here is 6 centimeters. This is a right triangle, just despite my drawing there. Sorry about that. And we want to find this leg here, x. It's a right triangle like that. Okay, so it's a right triangle, so the Pythagorean theorem applies. We have x squared, leg squared, plus leg squared equals the hypotenuse squared, right? That's the Pythagorean theorem. And this time, we're going to have to do a little bit of algebra. Subtracting 36 on both sides, we get then x squared equals 64. And then taking the square root of both sides, don't forget the plus or minus, right? We get x equals plus or minus 8. And then from there, we'll choose, this is geometry, so we're choosing x to be 8 centimeters. And we have all sides of the right triangle. Awesome. Now lastly, sometimes they'll give us problems where the lengths of the sides of the right triangle are given sort of in terms of like algebra. All right, so let's look at this. Here's my right triangle. Okay, but for this one, the base here is x, the height is x minus 1, and the hypotenuse is 5. Okay, applying the Pythagorean theorem here, we have x squared plus x minus 1 squared equals 20, or let's just say 5 squared, right? Take that extra step later, 5 squared. All right, and so we get like an algebraic equation that we're going to need to solve. There's going to be some algebra in this class, so let's get used to that. All right, to solve that, we know it's going to be a quadratic, so we have x squared plus. Distributing x minus 1 squared, I'll have x squared minus 2x plus 1, and that'll be equal to 25. Okay, you're going to have to distribute this or FOIL this, right? And then that's what you get. Now it's quadratic. Let's get same side like terms. We have 2x squared minus 2x plus 1 equals 25. And then subtracting 25, we then have 2x squared minus 2x minus 24 equals 0. Okay, so we have it in standard form equal to 0. This one has a GCF, so I'll go ahead and factor that out. Factoring out 2, I'll be left with x squared minus x minus 12. And then we can factor that guy further. X squared breaks up as x times x. 12 breaks up as 1 times 12, 2 times 6, or 3 times 4. The middle term has to be a negative 1, so we'll choose 3 times 4. And then to get a negative 1 for the middle term, the 4 better be negative, and the 3 better be positive. Okay, so that's called factoring. Once we get it factored, we then set each variable factor equal to 0. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to go ahead and ignore 2 because that's never going to be equal to 0. The only way this product can be equal to 0 is if this factor is 0 or that factor is 0, right? And so for this one, subtracting 3, I get x equals negative 3, and then here I get x equals 4. But again, we're doing geometry, so it doesn't make sense for the side of a triangle to be negative, so I'm going to throw that away. That's kind of extraneous. And I'm going to choose x equals 4 to be the only solution here. Now, once I know x is 4, I can go back to the problem, and I can plug it in, right? Because if x is 4, then I know this side has to be 4 units, and then this side is 4 minus 1, or x minus 1. That would be 3 units. And so this was just basically the 3, 4, 5, right, triangle in disguise. Okay, we have time for one more. Let's do one more. Okay, so you can see here I have a rectangular box, and they want us to find the diagonal from corner to corner inside the box. They want us to find the length of that diagonal. And we're given the box measures 3 centimeters by 4 centimeters by 5 centimeters. Okay, so these are our givens. Find the diagonal. Okay, so now to do that, what we're going to do is try to find right triangles in here and apply the Pythagorean theorem. So if I make the diagonal across the bottom like that, well, then I can form a right triangle here. I'll draw it in green, where the height is 4, but I don't really know what the base is. For that right triangle inside there, the length of the base is unknown. So I can't really apply the Pythagorean theorem because I have something unknown. I have a leg, and then the hypotenuse is unknown. So I sort of have two unknowns. Okay, so I'm going to need to find sort of this length right here, and that's going to be my goal. Now, if I look at the bottom triangle here, I can form another right triangle on the bottom of the box right here, where I know all the sides. So this is going to be a right triangle like that. And so for that red right triangle, I have the two legs, and the hypotenuse is unknown. And so I can figure that out by applying the Pythagorean theorem. I can say 3 squared plus 5 squared equals x squared, right? And I'll be able to find that hypotenuse there. In other words, 9 plus 25 equals x squared. That's going to be what? 34 equals x squared. And then extracting the root, taking the square root of both sides, don't forget the plus or minus, we get x equals plus or minus square root of 34. Well, we choose positive, right? Square root of 34. So I look on my picture then, and I can say, all right, now I have this leg of the green triangle, so I'll go ahead and erase that. This is the square root of 34 units. All right, so now for the green triangle, I do have the two legs. So we can set up the Pythagorean theorem for that. Right? We could say leg squared, so square root of 34 squared plus leg squared equals hypotenuse squared, right? Square root of 34 plus 4 squared equals d squared. Okay, when you square a square root, you get those sort of canceled. You get 34 plus 16 equals d squared. All right, in other words, 50 equals d squared. And then taking the square root of both sides, extracting the root, don't forget the plus or minus. And again, I'm going to choose the positive value, and I get d equals the square root of 50 units. Now, the square root of 50 can be simplified because 50 is 25 times 2, and the square root of 25 is 5. So that reduces or simplifies to 5 square root of 2, and measurement here is in units. And so that is the length of that diagonal that they wanted us to find. Okay? And so there you have it.